Hello, my Cocoa Puffs. It's Coco Peru. I'm coming to you again from my bathroom here in Van Nuys with my third installment of Cocoa Thoughts while in solitude, trying to enjoy the little things in life that someday I'm sure, well, I already realize they are the big things. I think I'm losing my voice. Oi! Which is, after being in solitude with my husband, he'd probably appreciate that right about now. But anyway, what I wanted to show you today is silly. You see, when I was growing up, my grandparents and my Aunt Marilyn and her family moved to Orlando. So we grew up going to visit them once, sometimes twice a year. And that always meant that we went to Disney World. And we would go with my Aunt Betty and her family. So eight of us, my Aunt Betty, her husband, Uncle Ed, my mother, my father, me, and my three cousins would get in a car. It was a station wagon. Eight of us in a station wagon with food and luggage for 2 days. No seatbelts. Anyway, we would drive down to Florida, and we would always go, like I said, to Walt Disney World. And I loved Walt Disney World. For me, it was a total escape from reality. I loved everything about it. I loved it so much, and I've said this before, I wanted to live in Disney World, not because of the rides, but because it was clean. The streets were clean, and people were friendly. And I just, not that people in the Bronx weren't friendly, it was just different. In fact, one morning we had gone out for breakfast there in Florida, and the waitress came over to our table, my aunt and uncle and all of us sitting around, and waitress is like, good morning. She had a southern twang, which I can't do. Good morning. Can I get you a glass of fresh squeezed Florida orange juice? How about some coffee? You know, just real super friendly. And when she walked away, my mother said, what the hell is her problem? You see, we just weren't used to it back then. This was the 70s. And Florida was very different than what you know about it now. Anyway, we would go to Disney World, and when we would leave at the end, we would get there when it opened, and we would leave when it closed, because we were going to suck up as much of Disney World as we can for our dollar. And on our way out, you'd pass all the stores, and my aunt and my mom would allow us kids to pick out one gift for ourselves. And this was mine 1 year, my Goofy doll. Isn't he cute? A little dusty. He is a little dusty. But I also had, from a separate trip, I was never allowed to buy more than one thing. I had a Pluto doll that I play with them together, but I don't know what happened to Pluto. I do know that he ended up missing an ear, and that bothered me. So I probably got rid of Pluto, poor thing. Anyway, I kept Goofy, and he reminds me, and this is the story that goes with Goofy. We had left, all eight of us in the car again, had left Disney World after a wonderful day. I had my Goofy doll. Before we even leave the parking lot, my cousins and I, we all fall asleep. The next thing I know, I am awakened by my mother and my Aunt Betty screaming, high-pitched screaming. And I open my eyes and the light is on in the car and I see arms just grabbing for me. And they pull me out of the car. And what had happened was, the gas tank had fallen out from the car and was hitting the ground and sparking. So my family, they thought we were going to blow up. So they yanked us out of the car. I grabbed my Goofy doll, and fortunately the car did not blow up. But while we were waiting for the tow truck and my aunt and uncle to come pick us up, because there were no cell phones back then. So I don't know how we got in touch with my aunt and uncle, but while we waited for them to pick us up, my aunt and my mom let us climb over this fence to get away from the traffic, where we would be safer on the other side of this fence. And we were running around this lake, rolling around on the beach, dead of night, throwing rocks in the water, carrying on my aunt. Next thing I know, I hear my Aunt Betty, my mother, and now my Aunt Marilyn shrieking, screaming for us to get back on the other side of the fence where they were, because what we didn't know, and my Aunt Marilyn told us, was that that lake was infested with alligators. We're from the Bronx. Alligators? I saw alligators in the Bronx Zoo. That's it. We didn't know they existed in real life out there in the lakes of Florida. So anyway, whenever I look at this beautiful Goofy doll, I think about how one night I almost blew up and got eaten by an alligator. But Goofy and I, we survived. We're survivors. Anyway, that's my story for today, and that's why I kept Goofy. It reminds me of that wonderful time and how much I absolutely adored Disney World. You know, I love Disney World so much. Some, if I really go kind of into a meditative state or just am about to fall asleep, I have vivid memories and I can remember smells. Do you have time for one more story? I've told this story before, but anyway, I'll come back over here now. There's my little shell that my husband, another thing that my husband does. He dives down when we're in Spain, all the way down to the bottom of the Mediterranean and picks me up a shell, walks it back to me. So I keep some of them that are pretty. Some of the other ones don't tell him. I just kind of drop on the way out. Now, I don't like, some of them aren't as pretty. And my little dolphin there. Anyway, but I'm not going to tell the story. Well, maybe I will because now I know you've. Anyway, the first year the Haunted Mansion opened up, I wanted so badly to come on it. The line was 2 hours, maybe even over 2 hours. My grandparents were with us this time, and my mother said, your grandparents are going to have to sit here in the hot sun on a bench waiting for us. I didn't give a shit. I wanted to go on that ride. They can wait. So they were nice grandparents. They sat on Clarence and Elsie. They sat on the bench and waited for my mother and I. We waited on this hot wall. I got all the way, and we got to the front door, and I saw that picture of the man that just sort of disintegrates. And I looked up at my mother and said, "I don't want to go on this ride." Scared the shit out of me. And my mother grabbed me by the back of my neck, my shirt, she wrapped it up in a hand. She said, "You're going on." And I was so terrified the whole ride, I kept my eyes closed. And my mother hit me on the side of my head the entire ride, going, "Open your eyes. God damn it, open your eyes." That's my first memory of the Haunted Mansion. Oh, good times. God, I did love Disney World. Anyway, so there's my little memory for today with my little Goofy doll that I kept. God, he's old. He's like 40 something by now. Anyway, I hope you are getting through this and appreciating the things in your life. All right, sweeties, I love you all. And I'll do another one soon. Bye now.